Good morning and Namaskar. Today we'll take a look at a pharma company, Marksans Pharma Ltd. It has performed reasonably well in Q1 FY21. It is engaged in research, manufacturing and marketing of generic pharmaceutical formulations across global markets. Its manufacturing facilities have been approved by US FDA, UK MHRA, Australian TGA, etc. Robust product portfolio is there in CVS, CNS, anti-diabetic pain management, gastroenterological and anti-allergics. It's marketing globally. Management consists of Mark Seldanha, Chairman and Managing Director, Sandra Seldanha, Whole-Time Director, Sandra Seldanha, Vardhaman Vikramaditya Jain, another Whole-Time Director. Now let's take a brief look at the latest results. Net sales are 331 crores. Compared to previous quarter, 335 crores, slight reduction, 1.25% reduction quarter on quarter. But June last year, it was 245 crores only. Therefore, compared to year on year, the increase is 35.15%. So, 331 crores versus 245 crores year on year, 35.15% increase. Very good. Year on year is very good. Quarter on quarter, it is flat. Net profit is 49.37 crores compared to 42.7 crores in the previous quarter and 22.5 crores in the year ago quarter. So here, quarter on quarter increase is there 15.5% and year on year increase is there 119.6%. So net sales have increased 35.15% year on year. Net profit has increased 119.6% year on year. So, well done, Marksans Pharma. Equity is 40.93, consistent. Basic EPS is 1.2 compared to just 1 in the previous quarter and 0.52 in year ago quarter. Here also 130% improvement year on year, 20% improvement quarter on quarter. Now, the current market price is 43.65. Because it has done well, tomorrow it is expected to increase. 43.65 today, because only buyers were there. There were no sellers. 52-week low is 9.9 and 52-week high is 43.6. That is, today's price is the highest. Price earning is 9.09, so there is scope for improvement in prices. Volumes are quite good, 84 lakhs. Selling and buying is easy, but today only buyers were there were no sellers. So 43.65 it has come from 9.9 year ago. Now historically, if you see, 1 year before, the low price, the price was 17. Now 43.65, increase is 157%. 2 years before, the price was 29.25. in the last 1 year, price has fallen actually. So 49% increase from that level. 1 year before, the price was lower. 2 years before, the price was higher. 3 years before, it was still higher at 41.45. So, currently it is at 43.65, 3 years before also it was at 41.45, only for in 3 years 5.31% increase. But 3 months before if you take, it's about 20 rupees only price was there, only during these 3 months it has gone up by leaps and bounds to 43.65, 121%. Now, shareholding pattern, if you look at that, promoters hold a reasonably good 48.25%, pledge is zero. FIIs hold 2.48% and DIIs hold 7.79%, insurance companies nil, financial institutions 0.64, mutual funds zero, other DIIs 7.15, public 41.48%. Reasonably good pattern of shareholding. Now, if you look at the strengths, EPS has been growing trailing 12 months. Now, ROE and EPS have been very attractive. Return on equity is improving during the last 2 years. Return on assets also is increasing during the last 2 years. Growth in net profit and net profit margin, both quarter on quarter and year on year, both are increasing. Debt is very low. Pledge is also zero. Increasing revenue every quarter during the last 3 quarters. Profits have been increasing the last 4 quarters. Annual net profits have been increasing during the last 2 years. Book value is improving during the last 2 years. Zero promoter pledge. FIAs want to increase their shareholding. So price momentum is there. During the last 3 months, very good price momentum, especially March, after March, April, May, June, etc., the curve has been steeply moving upwards. Prior to that, it was low. Valuation, if you look at that, market cap is 1,787 crores of rupees, price earning is 46.94, trailing, now we are talking about trailing 12 months, price earning 46.94, book value 12.35, all trailing 12 months. Book value is latest as on March. Dividend percentage is 10%. Industry price earning 34.85. EPS trailing 12 months is 0.9. Now 1.2, something like that. Price to book 3.53. Dividend yield is 0.23%. Face value is just 1 rupee. So on 1 rupee, 1.2 EPS is quarterly EPS is good. It is improving. Now, in the press release, they have said total revenue is 331.3 crores compared to 247.2 crores. Improvement is 34% year on year. EBITDA is 70.2 crores compared to 34.6 crores in the last year. Increase is 103%. EBITDA margin 21.2% now compared to 14% only year on year. Profit after tax is 49.4 crores compared to 22.5 crores in last year, same quarter, 119.6% growth. So, reasonably well done, Marksans. Commenting on that, Managing Director Seldan has says, I am happy to state that we have achieved another quarter of robust performance. Last quarter also it was good. He says another quarter of robust performance, wherein we have achieved the highest EBITDA of 70.2 crores. This was due to all-round growth across geographies. So like that, we remain cautiously confident of delivering such superior performance going forward also. So in future also, we are going to achieve like that, he says. So business highlights is, company achieved revenue of 144.2 crores from Europe and UK. Formulation business in Q1 FY21 as compared to 100.9 crores. So growth in Europe and UK is around 43% for 1 year. US and North American formulation growth is 29%. Australia and New Zealand formulation business has grown 10.8%. Rest of the world has business was 19.4 crores. Now, of course, we have covered US, UK, etc. Now, see, the point is, it has been growing in every segment. See, it has grown in Europe and UK, 43% year on year. In US and North America, it has grown 29%. In Australia and New Zealand, 10.8%. Rest of the world also, 12.3%. Okay. So, overall, 34% growth. Will it grow like this next quarter? Marshall Dan has says, yes, we will grow. Cautiously optimistic. So, nothing untoward should come in between. So, that's all that he says. Okay. So, let us believe him. So, Marksans Pharma has done well in this quarter. Let us hope for better times ahead also. and I'll come before you with another very good company. Thank you.